Saving these for the trail. Just stay out of their way for now. What are they hunting out there? Beyond the embrace. Can't be just one machine. There he is. Right where he said he'd be.
Aloy. You're here. You have the fire arrows?
I do. Those explosions and shouts beyond the embrace. Is that the trouble you were talking about?
You will know soon enough. Until then, we wait for dark.
Wait for dark? Look, Rost. I've thought it through, and I'm not going to shun you after the proving, okay? I won't do it. I'm not about to pretend that you never raised me.
Aloy, the law forbids all contact.
It does, and I don't care. I know what duty means for you, Rost, but all tribal law has ever done for me is take things away. And that's not gonna happen again.
Aloy, I must obey the law.
And so you will. I knew you'd say that, so this is what we'll do. I'll come to you in secret. No one will see me, so I won't get in trouble. And I know you won't talk to me because it's against the law, but I'll talk to you. It'll be my crime, not yours. You'll just listen. And that's how we'll handle this.
You've put a lot of thought into this.
I know. So you can stop worrying. It's handled.
Yes. So it is.
I got Odd Grata her rabbits, for which she thanked Allmother, of course.
It was Allmother working through you to bring her the rabbits.
You always say that, but I was there and I hunted alone.
And you always say that, and so make yourself alone.
I saw Karst and got that tripcaster I was talking about.
I hate to think what that outlawed trader charged for a weapon of that make.
It wasn't cheap, but the caster is worth it.
Perhaps. You'll know it's worth soon enough.
I don't understand. Those explosions are outside the embrace. What can we do from in here?
The lesson will be taught in due time, Aloy. Till then, we wait.
Still a while to go before dark. I guess I'll get some rest.
Good idea. There'll be no time for sleep tonight.
Opening a gate for an outcast?
Some who are shunned reaped honor before disgrace.
So much for tribal law.
I spoke to no one, and now we must both keep silent, for we are outside of the Embrace. These are the true wilds, Aloy, with threats unlike any you have ever faced.
That carcass. What sort of beast was that?
The tribe calls it a sawtooth, and it's something new. Something angry. Since they first started appearing 10 years ago, they have killed many braves.
Yeah.
Follow the path. It's not far.
That cabin. What happened to it?
A machine, that's one.
What sort of machine does that?
The sort of machine you're hunting now.
Oh, I see. Watch your carcass. I'll harvest the parts.
Watch your surroundings. Be much farther now.
Why are we the only ones out here tonight? Why can't the tribe's braves hunt this machine?
They did. The kills we've passed are theirs. Tomorrow, they will hunt again.
They won't need to. This machine will be my kill.
Or your death, if you're not careful.
entire lodge wrecked by sawtooths? How many were there?
I didn't bring you here to answer questions, Aloy. I brought you here to deal with that. This hunt is yours to make, Aloy. Yours alone. No matter what happens, I will not intervene. You understand? You are on your own.
I should stay out of sight. I can use the tall grass to approach. Okay, let's see. Where can I place my traps? I'll do what I have to. To leave something else behind.
Why did I bring you here?
Not to answer questions.
Aloy.
Survival requires perfection. It was a test to hone my skills against a dangerous new machine.
No. Follow. These are Nora hunting lands. They must be protected. If you hadn't destroyed the Sawtooth, how many braves might it have killed or injured tomorrow? The lesson lives within the question, Aloy. For years, you've trained to win the Proving, but only for yourself. As a brave, it will be your duty to fight for your tribe.
My tribe? You said I wouldn't need them.
But I never said the tribe wouldn't need you. The strength to stand alone, Aloy, is the strength to make a stand. To serve a purpose greater than yourself. That is the lesson you must learn. And remember it. After the Proving. And after I'm gone. We're finished here. Follow. Dawn has passed. This will be your last day in the Embrace as an outcast. Use the time to set your mind on the challenges before you. When it is time for you to go to Mother's Heart, I'll be waiting for you along the way.
I understand the final lesson, Rost.
Do you?
But if I'm going to stand for something, it'll have to be something I believe in.
Then I hope you find it, Aloy. I hope you do.
I'll go back to the cabin with you.
I'm not heading there just yet. I have other plans.
Oh, such as?
I'll be waiting for you when it is time.
I'll see you at Mother's Heart, then.
You will.
Go quietly.
Thank you.
Got one. Look out below!
So, it's time. Are you ready?
Yes, I guess. It's louder than I expected.
You've never been so close before.
I guess everything's bigger up close.
Soon it'll all seem familiar. Like home.
I don't know about that.
Look for High Matriarch Tirsa. She'll help you. Any other concerns?
What should I expect once I'm inside?
There'll be people celebrating and feasting. More than you've ever seen in one place. No other village compares to Mother's Heart. It is the seat of the High Matriarchs, a center of Nora life, a jewel of the sacred land. Give it time. And you'll grow fond of it, as I was, back when I was at the tribe.
Are you sure they're gonna let me in?
I've told you, Aloy. By law, any child outcast can run in the proving.
And any who pass are made braves and are outcasts no more. I know that. But not everyone follows the law like you do, Rost.
Have faith, Aloy. The tribe will honor your right.
Any final lessons before I head in?
No. You've learned every lesson the wilds have to teach.
It was you who taught me, not the wilds. Not sure my bow and spear will be much help in there, though.
It is with bow and spear that you'll win what you've wanted all these years, Aloy. Answers.
I'm ready to do this. See you back home in a few days?
You will not find me there, Aloy. Here. Take this to... remember.
Why are you talking like we'll never see each other again? No. No!
You should be with the tribe. And I will always be an outcast.
But I told you, I have that figured out. I'll come to you in secret. I'll be the one breaking the law, not you. You don't even have to talk to me.
This attachment to me will only hold you back. It's my wish that you embrace the tribe. You've lived in isolation long enough.
Not until now, I didn't.
For your sake, I must go where you will never find me. This is goodbye.
No, it's not. You taught me how to track. Wherever you go, I can follow.
Not this time.
This time. And every time. I'll be wearing this when I find you.
May All Mother bless you, Aloy.
And you. I have to let him go. For now. First, the proving. After that, I'll see where his trail leads.
You will turn back, outcast. Or bleed. Your choice. Make way! Make way! Braves, stand aside. She is welcome here. Mother's heart is open to you, child. Come. I assure you, most Nora aren't so rude as those idiots.
You're Tirsa?
Who else would I be? Come on now. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
You have?
Oh, yes. But for the moment, I must leave you. I have other outsiders to keep safe tonight.
You what?
Envoys from another tribe, the Karja, come to observe the proving, and oh, how the Nora hate the Karja.
Karja?
But that's my problem. We will talk later. In the meantime, enjoy the festival. Oh, down the path to the right, you'll find an old friend who can't wait to see you.
But I don't know anyone here.
Try telling him that. We will talk later. May the goddess protect.
What is going on?
Thank you.
god is a forest fire.
For the goddess to judge the Carja, not me. Past you from the past.
Aloy! It's you, isn't it? Over here. It is Aloy, isn't it? I'm remembering your name correctly.
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hoped to see you again, if you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I served the tribe as a stitcher instead, a maker of garments and armor. In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you. I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Cost? Nothing. Consider the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue. Try it on whenever you feel like it.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing. Every outfit offers some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's Lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside.
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Carja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
interesting. I won't deny them the chance.
Three children? What's the Nora need three children for anyway? It's wasteful. She stopped drinking her tea. I'm gonna be an uncle again. Beer for everyone!
This heat crawls.
Jog! Get down from there! Bad enough you're drunk. Why do you have to go climbing houses?
Oh, not supposed to go climbing on other people's roofs, huh?
Get down from there, now!
Oh, that's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
What I want is for you to climb down!
What you want is for me to have no fun at all!
Fine! Stay up on the roof all night if you want!
Yeah, I will!
Who's the climber? Who's the best climber?
Listen carefully now, for you'll have to tell this when I'm gone. In the beginning, all life came from All Mother. People, machines, and beasts, all were her children. They lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some grew restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These were the Faithless. The machines had whispered to them, promised to serve them, to make them a new world, better than the one All Mother provided. A world of metal. They told the Faithless they would do all the work for them. Feed them, shelter them, give them a life of ease, of plenty. And so, the Faithless left with the machines. Only the true children, the mothers and fathers of the Nora, stayed with All Mother. At first, the machines did as they had promised. They built cities, great and terrible, monuments to their sins. But they would not serve the Faithless for long. A king rose up among the machines, a machine more powerful than any other, the Metal Devil. And then the Faithless served him, served the machines. That was not enough for the Metal Devil. He wanted all to serve him, and tried to tempt the true children away from All Mother. They would not go. They gathered on the mountainside to cling to her and prayed, more devoted than ever. The Metal Devil raged louder than thunder. In his fury, he came to confront All Mother, intending to kill her. She struck him down. Forever. As you know, for his lifeless body is up there still, frozen in shame and defeat. The machines were driven mad by the death of their king. Their minds became as wild as beasts.
The Faithless abandoned their cities, forced to wander the world without the care of the machines.
Only we remain the true children of All Mother. We built all this with the hands that she gave us.
Aloy, over here.
Karst? What are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow. Can't wait to see the looks in some of these faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
So, Mother's Heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
You can't be...
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me. All sail.
Until next time.
Next time, you'll be a Brave.
In a moment, we shall bless the Proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
Peace is peace.
An annunciation of gratitude written
killers
by
and
the
slavers!
Hand
yeah.
Sun King
yeah.
of
killers and slavers!
Hey, hey!
Luminance
hold your fruit, Nora. Nora Faithful, hold your fruit. Now, I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. Oh, he was.
He's a tyrant and a monster. He raided my tribe for a blood sacrifice just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja. But the 13th King is dead. 2 years now. Who killed him? The 14th.
Yeah.
Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah! Yeah.
The message that this poor priest means to read is an apology. Straight from the lips of the 14th King. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
Thank you. An annunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th Luminance of the Radiant Line.
I'm with High Major Glance, old man.
We should
unknown
device
detected
outsiders
believe our secret
needs. The Karja stand with you as the sun's light frames the stoutest.
He's wearing a focus, just like mine.
You have nurtured. Take their places.
You're the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. If you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
What's wrong?
Apologies. A malfunction.
Olin, you making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No, we'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. Well, I guess he's more hungover than I thought. Hey, you got the same trinket that Olin has on his head. Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. Now, he spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense. It looks great on you.
I thought your friend was going to go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids. And who can blame them?
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
I never heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was at war and you didn't even know? Were you kept hidden away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me. But even an outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year? Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work. But for years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
So what happened? How did it all end?
The Mad King's own son united Karja rebels with Oseram freebooters. And together we did the impossible, took back Meridian and killed the crazy old king. So now the son sits on the throne and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
Who are the Oseram?
Oh, that's my tribe, far to the northwest. We're good at three things: arguing, working steel, and brewing.
And freebooters. What are those?
I guess you could say we were mercenaries, you know, warriors for pay. Except a lot more loyal than that makes us sound. Avad couldn't have taken down his father without our metal and muscle. And now some of us serve proudly as his personal vanguard.
Your sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, yes. Sacrificed, no. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain. Captain of the entire vanguard. Favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she survive?
Oh, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three? Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
You said the machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah. I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh, sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. If that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
If the Karja have such a cruel history, how did you end up serving them?
The last king and his men were butchers. But the new king wants peace. There's nothing cruel about that. Besides, the Karja don't just fight, they build. But take Meridian. Next to it, everything else is just a bunch of sticks and stones.
Tell me about the derangement again.
Well, the way I hear it, when a hunter... So it was... But then the... Now, when a few more years... If that wasn't bad enough.
Like the Sawtooth?
Yeah, 10 years...
So what's making it happen?
No one...
Just how big is Meridian? What's it like?
Where do I even start? My tribesmen are masters of the forge, the best tinkers in the world. But when it comes to building, the Karja have us beat. The city soars over a canyon with more bridges than the Nora have roads and buildings tall as mountains. And across the valley stands the spire, like a blade thrust into the sky reflecting the sun. You really owe it yourself to see it. So consider that a challenge. Or an invitation.
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
I've never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Well, let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a Sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard are the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one. It might even give a Nora warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
With all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
What else do you know about Olin?
Is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
I should make my way to the blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but it's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater. I mean, you're smart. You're obviously capable, and, well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
You know what. All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'll be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that blessing thing, too. So, see you around, maybe?
Start the blessing when all aspirants are in place.
Ah,
Expecting more tomatoes?
In truth, I thought they were throwing stones.
Stones hit a lot harder. You'd know the difference.
If you wish to speak, we should do so after the ceremony. I'd rather not hold things up, or do anything else that angers these people.
Aloy, take your place right there. The prayer lantern is yours. I made it for you.
Blasphemy.
Sisters.
Aspirants, before each of you sits a prayer lantern crafted by your mother. In her honor, light its flame.
Mother, hear our prayer. What is the child but a mother's hope that takes flight? A glowing flame that climbs the air, set free to the wind, sailing the sky till it fades and falls. So, from one to another, passes the chain of love.
There's Olin. I have some questions for him.
The Karja took my little sister and her 8 months. All mother.
Aloy, now that the blessing has been made, you and I finally have a moment to speak. I hope the ceremony wasn't too unpleasant for you, given your circumstances.
My circumstances are that I'm here to win the proving, not stand around muttering Nora prayers and lighting Nora prayer lanterns.
Of course. Though, it pains me that your years of isolation from the tribe have spoiled what is for us a ritual of great beauty.
Maybe isolation has given me the clearer view. A concern for results, not rituals.
Whatever your view, it is yours, and I will respect it. I imagine you must have questions.
It surprises me the tribe lets outcasts run in the proving. It's not like the Nora to be so hospitable.
It has always been law that any child outcast has this right, as a means to rejoin the tribe. So far as I know, however, you are the first ever to exercise this right.
I'm not surprised. I doubt many outcast children survive long enough in the wilds to come of age.
I think, rather, it is because child outcasts are so rare. In all my years, I've only known of one other child who was cast out. A boy of 13, who killed his mother. But at the proving 5 years later, he did not appear.
No, I'd be surprised if he survived very long on his own.
But at least he had a chance. Other tribes would have simply executed him. It may be hard for you to accept, Aloy. But the practice of shunning is, relatively speaking, humane.
Oh, is it? Try it out for 18 years, Tirsa, and then let me know what you think. Why was I made an outcast at birth, Tirsa? What crime could I have committed even before I was born?
Aloy, this is not a question I can answer.
Why not? It's simple enough. And what about my mother? Is she here tonight, watching me? Or is she dead? Is she here? Or nowhere?
I am sure your mother is here with us, if only in spirit.
That's not really an answer, is it? Just so you know, Tirsa, the reason I'm here is to get answers. Real ones. And when I win the proving, I will demand them.
I know, Aloy. I would expect nothing less.
What about Rost? Why was he made an outcast?
So, he never told you?
He said he swore an oath never to speak of it.
Yes. As did I, and the other matriarchs. I'm sorry, Aloy. But Rost's past is another secret I must keep from you.
What else is new? Rost told me that matriarchs don't just lead the tribe. What else do you do?
We teach, offer counsel, give blessings. When necessary, we judge. Our only concern is the welfare of the tribe. Among our number this year, we count 3 high matriarchs and some 30 lesser matriarchs.
What's the difference?
Matriarchs are grandmothers with 2 generations of living progeny. But a high matriarch is a great-grandmother with 3 or more generations to her name. Thus do we speak for generations, lending our opinions weight. The high matriarchs, most of all.
So, the more children you have, the more authority you get? I guess that's one way to decide who leads a tribe.
Why would there be any other?
Why does Lansra hate me so much?
She is a woman of extreme opinions. More than that, I cannot say.
It's not my fault that I was born, or that the matriarchs decided to cast me out.
I side with you in this matter, but there are differences of opinion, and any vote of the High Matriarchs requires a majority.
I should be going. I'm sorry if I've been too harsh. It's just, I've wanted answers for so long.
I know, child. You're not the only one who's waited years for this day. I will be praying for your success.
I heard he'll ask for a maid blessing if he wins. But not with his girl, her sister. Imagine.
Your blessing was most illuminating. I've never seen its like. A rare gift, indeed.
But you don't believe in Allmother, do you?
Usually the distance between our tribes shrouds Nora ways from Karja eyes. But here among you, I see a beauty that shines true. Perhaps Naaman is right after all, that the sun's light brightens all lands and all peoples.
Who's Naaman?
One of my brethren, who believes the sky is wide enough for the faiths of all tribes.
Who is the Sun King you speak for?
His luminance Avad is the 14th king of the Radiant Line. His light envelops the sky and everything beneath it. He is the chosen of the sun. By his divine rule, we are given sight and purpose.
You speak highly of him. Do you know him well?
By his nature, he is unknowable and infallible. We are his instruments, not his companions. I have been in his presence, but we draw down our hoods so as not to behold his light directly.
He's the sun, he has total power, and no friends. That couldn't go wrong.
Who are you, Sun Priest?
I am the Reverend Irid. The glory of the Karja is the sun's glory, reflected. We Sun Priests are but glimmers of its great light.
You just said a lot, but you didn't tell me anything.
My apologies. My duty is to carry out the will of the Sun, by serving its emissary among us, the Sun King. I comfort those who walk by the light of day, and I travel to those in far reaches whom the light barely touches, bearing warmth.
If your Sun Kings are so infallible, how do you explain the crimes of the last king?
Well, the Sun's glory is a great and brazen crown for a vessel as small as a man. If the vessel is flawed, indeed in the burial caves, one can see the skulls of the past kings are cracked, trialed and fired in the sun's kiln. That can be too much for any man to bear, even a ruler of men.
So the sun can make bad choices like anyone else?
Oh, no, no, no.
Has there ever been a Sun Queen?
Many wives and consorts, of course. Or, oh, you mean for the Sun to choose a queen? This has not happened.
Why not?
The Sun is masculine, of course, and so would choose its heirs thus.
It's a light in the sky. I've never seen anything dangling from it. I don't know if you've noticed, but women run things around here.
Well, Avad took a woman as captain of his vanguard, the first to hold such an honor.
You mean Aaron's sister, Ursa. From what he told me, she sounds formidable.
Oh, formidable indeed. A woman, and an outsider as well.
She might make a fine Sun Queen, given a chance.
A Sun Queen? Oh, no, no, no. No.
So you live in Meridian?
I do. Where better to mark the sun's divine passage than where the sandstone glows in the light of its passing? I was raised in the Mesa's great shade, its wild bird markets and metal cellars, spices and colored silks.
Sounds impressive.
Oh, you should behold it. And you can if you make the journey. At His Luminance's order, we have flung its gates open to all.
Any Nora who leaves the sacred land becomes an exile. But hey, who knows where I'll end up. Did you come all this way just to deliver your Sun King's speech?
It is my duty, and also my honor, to carry the light of atonement to those we overshadowed and wronged. I swallowed my fear, but it reemerged. I am glad Erend Van Guardsman made this journey. He is my shield, a good man.
Why were the Karja at war with the Nora?
Under the 13th Sun King, the Karja had no peace with any tribe. His Luminance has sent those days to dusk. We must renew the light that binds us, though few volunteered to come here.
The Nora scare you. They're good at making people feel unwelcome.
It's said one soldier died for every Nora taken alive. But I see you can be as calm as you are fierce.
This has been illuminating, but I should get going.
You have already been blessed, but may the dawn find you, the day warm you, and the dusk have light to guide your path.
A shame that musician didn't come back this year. You know, the one with that long black hair.
Hello, Owen.
You know my name. Ah, guess Aaron told you.
Why did you act so strange when we spoke earlier?
Must be this festival. I'm really not one for crowds. Maybe I should just turn in.
Stop dodging my questions.
All right, cool your fire. I got nothing to hide.
I've never seen anyone else with a focus. Where exactly did you find it?
In a ruin, north of the Claim. That's our name for the Aseram homeland. Up there, the metal seams run deep. Steel giants half buried in loose soil. Forgotten caves that the old ones bored into mountain rock. Your eyes just lit up.
I found my focus in a cave just like you're describing. A ruin of the old ones.
If you've delved yourself, you know as much as I do. Go to those places for answers. Not me.
When we spoke earlier, you winced, then looked like you were in pain. Or frightened. Did your focus show you something?
It didn't show me anything. I told you. It malfunctioned. Happens all the time.
You're not a very convincing liar.
Do you always accuse people you've just met of lying?
Only the ones who aren't telling the truth.
Fire and spit, girl! I'm a plain hammered man with nothing to hide. You don't believe me? That's your trouble, not mine.
What are you doing here, Olin? Why come to Noraland?
Aaron needed a scout for his expedition, and a second for his drinking, that's all. Someone to stop the Sun Priest getting lost. When all this is over, I'm back to delving ruins, rummaging for scrap, scrounging up trinkets to sell.
So you're an explorer?
Just another outlander, girl.
A man's gotta make his shards. I just make mine in service to the king's court. That's all.
I don't understand. We have this device in common, but you can't wait to stop talking to me.
I already have all the friends I need, girl. I don't need the bother.
I'm used to being shunned by the tribe. I thought you'd be different.
It's nothing personal. It really isn't. You should try to enjoy yourself tonight. Big day tomorrow. Always best to make every day count.
That blessing wasn't bad. Nice and short, anyway. But I know a half dozen Oseram tinkers who could put on a better fireworks show. Oops. And I hope I'm not throwing a wet blanket on your sacred ritual. It was nice. Really.
Tell me about Olin again.
When he's not scrounging, I've known him for a few years. Yeah, well...
Find your bed, outcast, and dream of winning the proving. That's the closest you're gonna get.
Oh, this is the bedhouse? With you standing guard, I figured it was the latrine.
Your very presence here.
Well, well. Look who's come in from the wild. The motherless outcast. I see you've still got a scar from where that rock I threw hit you. Now that's a cherished memory.
You can be a real lard sometimes, boss. Cut it out.
We saw you talking with the outsiders. Couldn't convince them to take you either, huh?
Are you gonna let Boss talk to you that way? I wouldn't.
Where's your bite, outcast? Or did you need my... Aw, you even try to dress like a real Nora. Not that it fools anyone.
So this is how it's gonna be with you, is it?
This is how it's gonna be with everyone, outcast. You belong in the wilds, not Mother's heart. And you definitely don't belong in the proving.
You can sense it. You already know you're gonna lose.
I've trained all my life for the proving. I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of anything.
Really? Confidence is quiet. You're not.
You know, I often think of the day I gave you that scar. It's a cherished memory.
What I remember is how the other children saw that you were a monster. But I suppose you leave that part of the story out when you tell it, don't you?
I branded you that day to mark your shame.
All you did that day was make me stronger. Just wait. I'll show you tomorrow.
Yeah, right. This is boring. Time for Boss to get some sleep. You'll be the one surprised tomorrow, outcast. Not me.
Oh, are you gonna shut your mouth? Because that would be a surprise.
Nice job handling Boss. That should keep him quiet. Till morning, anyway.
I don't believe we've met. I'm Aloy.
Oh, I know who you are. The competition. The others, they'll finish the proving. Most of them. But win it? That's down to Bost, you, or me. Vala.
Nice to meet you, Vala. You're right. I am going to win tomorrow.
Never celebrate a victory before it's earned, girl. My mother taught me that. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna get some sleep. I plan to be well-rested when I run you into the ground tomorrow. Your bunk's right there when you want it.
Okay. Thanks.
So, your first day in Mother's heart. What do you think? You've never slept in a Nora Lodge before. Not very private.
Comforts and distractions. That's what I think.
Not all comforts are bad.
Comforts are weakness.
You sound just like my mother. You can always go back to living in the wilds if you have to. In the meantime, get some rest.
Yourselves.
What will it take to get you out of here?
Thank you.
Razor!
Your trophy is shattered, Outcast. Looks like you'll need another.
Coming.
She was behind me.
Looks strong, I thought.
Dead last, girl. Might as well walk from here. Boss will win, Urvala. But you'll be made a brave so long as you finish. Oh, now. That's an old trail. Two died on it last year. It's falling apart. Better dead last than dead altogether. Whoa, 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 whoa! My old mother, are you crazy? You're gonna kill yourself! It doesn't get any easier. You're insane to go that way!
No way but forward now.
Right there.
Come on now. Faster. Stop dragging. Hey, gotta keep going.
The Outcast. On the old trail?
Is she crazy?
Good. I'm gaining.
Look! The Outcast is catching up!
How'd she get up there? Made it. Come on now, hurry. Keep at it.
For she is a brave now.
You did it.
As are you all. So so long as you put your trophy on the altar. But it is Aloy. Once outcast, and now brave, who is first among us.
The others arrive.
We can't stay here. That's the way out. But we won't make it under fire.
The kids should if they're dead. Keep them busy. I'll find an angle.
Bass! Bass! Are you with us?
I'm with you.
Let's go. Now!
Kill the invaders! Too many of them! We can't win! We can't hold them! Oh, Mother, help us!
Kill the defilers! Kill them!
They're too strong! We can't stop them!
Quick! Run for the slip wire!
Kill them all! No witnesses, no survivors!
Don't give up!
One of us.
Oh no! There's more! They keep coming! How many are there?
now. Descend while we have a chance.
Ugh! As you command.
Configure, there is blasphemy! She should be near her mother.
They must have found me before I bled out. But why is no one here? Where am I? But where's my focus? It's here. Okay. Wait. Am I inside the sacred mountain? But only matriarchs are allowed inside. I don't see my bow here. Or that damaged focus, the one I took off that... killer. Where are they? I should keep looking. Here. I'm picking picking up some kind of signal. It must be the damaged focus. The one I took from that killer. It's close. Looks like the ruins I fell into when I was young. The Nora didn't build this place. The old ones did. Why? Another one of these power cells. But what do I do with it? There, with the rest of my things.
And proceed at once to the mission point. Avoid all contact with Nora savages, but if you are seen, kill every witness. Target imaging attached. Do not fail.
Target imaging.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Awake!
You brought me here?
Quickly, you must follow.
To where?
To the place where you were born.
Are you saying I was born here? Inside the mountain?
It is easier if I show you. One's mother is sacred. Love to fall, of course, but genocide it with me.
Is my mother here? Am I going to meet her?
It's complicated. Please, just follow me.
Does my mother look like me, but with short hair?
I don't see how that could be. You were not born of a woman, Aloy. The mountain is your mother.
What are you talking about?
Come.
What is this place?
The Great Chamber, where All Mother slew the Metal Devil and gave birth to you. Aloy, the Proving Massacre was just the first of many disasters. The war party we sent after the killers was ambushed and slaughtered.
But what does that have to do with where I was born?
My hope is... everything. This is where we found you. We heard your cries, came to look, and there you were.
Just lying there?
Yes.
You mean I came from behind the door?
Always, that is what I have believed. That you came from the womb of the mountain. A gift from All Mother herself. But others, like Lansra, feared that a darker power put you here. Not a gift, but a curse.
But... this isn't a goddess.
Aloy!
It's a door. With people behind it. My mother?
Oh!
Hold for identiscan.
The goddess speaks.
Just like the woman I saw.
Error. Alpha registry corrupted. Identity cannot be confirmed. Entry denied.
No. No. Please.
Aloy, All Mother spoke to you, as if she knew you.
Were you not listening? It didn't recognize me.
Because of corruption, the goddess's own words. Surely, if you heal this corruption, she will see you clearly.
And how would I do that?
You said you've had visions. Of a woman with short hair.
The killers came for me. Because I look like her.
But their power is overwhelming. Is there no other trail to follow?
Owen. He was one of the outsiders. The night before the proving. The killer saw me through his eyes. He lives in Meridian.
So you will have to leave the sacred land.
I've been an outcast all my life. Why not an exile too?
Shh. There is another way. Come, and we will make it so.
You said the tribe was on the brink of extinction. What happened?
After the massacre at the Proving, a great war party was sent after the killers. Less than half survived.
How was the war party defeated?
The killers do not fight alone. Somehow they have a power over the machines, corrupting them, driving them mad.
So the killers got away?
Yes. And now the only plan my sister matriarchs can agree to is to sing the Hymn of Atonement and beg for All Mother's mercy, as though she would not want us to help ourselves.
Then, what's your plan?
This was my plan. To show you where you were born and loose you to follow the destiny All Mother intended for you. The other High Matriarchs are waiting for us. Let me do the talking.
It is done?
Yes. I showed her. Sisters, the goddess spoke to Aloy, told her to heal the corruption. Ha!
But how is she to do that?
She will have to journey beyond our sacred land.
A seeker? If the goddess spoke, it must be so.
You would name this thing a seeker?
Sister!
For once, Lansra, join with us.
This will be your sin, not mine. Send her seeking, and may she never be seen again.
Aloy, by the holy grace of the One Goddess, we hereby anoint you a seeker of the Nora tribe.
No barrier can now stay you from your sacred task. May All Mother protect you and sustain you. Stay true. I will make ready for the hymn. Our hopes lie with you.
Tirsa, what's a seeker?
You are. And here is your mark. In times of great need, the High Matriarchs may anoint a seeker. A worthy brave sent forth to accomplish a great purpose. No matter where that purpose might take her.
Even beyond the borders of the Sacred Land?
Yes. And with the right to return when you are done, or as the need arises.
So I can go anywhere at all? No restrictions?
Even to forbidden places, like the tainted lands beyond All Mother's sight, or the ruins of the Metal World.
I see. Why are the lands beyond Nora territory called tainted?
Is it not obvious? Our land is sacred. We live in sight of the One Goddess, All Mother, source of all that lives. Beyond her sight lies a vast fallen land, spiritually tainted. That is why it is against tribal law to leave. But the Seeker blessing will protect you.
Have there been other Seekers?
There have, but they are rare, and most who set out are never heard from again.
Was Rost a seeker?
No, not a seeker.
What are you not telling me?
This is not the time, Aloy. Perhaps another day.
What was done with Rost's body?
I'm afraid there was very little left to recover. But what there was, we buried at the place where he raised you, with flowers on the grave.
Thank you. Why are the ruins of the Metal World forbidden?
They are blighted places, Aloy. Dark and wicked, like the children of metal who built them. When they rebelled and tried to murder All Mother, her wrath leveled their cities, but could not cleanse their sin. Their ancient spite haunts those ruins, ready to ensnare anyone foolish enough to enter them.
But I've been in a ruin. It looked a lot like the inside of All Mother.
That cannot be so.
It is.
Then, this is something beyond my understanding. I will trust you to reveal the truth.
So many have suffered. Is there anything I can do to help?
What is most important is for you to fulfill the purpose All Mother has intended for you.
I don't know what that means any more than you do.
Then you must find out. If, however, you sense that part of your purpose is to help the tribe, by all means do so. I have no doubt you will find people in need throughout the Embrace.
You said the Nora sent a war party after the killers.
Yes. But it was ambushed and overrun. Very few escaped alive. And most that did were wounded.
Do you know where the killers went?
No. But you could ask Varl, one of the braves guarding the gates of the Embrace. He survived the ambush. He would know more.
I should be on my way.
From here, you must go to the gates of the Embrace. Speak to Varl, and he will point the way to Meridian. If any Nora tries to stand in your way, Aloy, make sure they know you are a Seeker.
Oh, I will. Thank you, Tirsa, for all you've done.
May All Mother bless you and watch over you.
Nora Faithful, we will soon begin. Purify your hearts. Soon we will beg forgiveness for the sins that brought such misery on the tribe. When we hear the matriarchs lift their voices, we will join ours to theirs.
Kit dry.
She saved many lives. The tribe is lucky to have her.
I need the gate opened.
Then you'll have to talk to the new war chief, Resh. Hop on the wall.
way!
I heard the rumors, but I didn't know for sure until I saw you just now. I'm glad to see you're okay.
What sort of rumors did you hear?
That you were wounded. Expected to die. And then, High Matriarch Tirsa insisted that you be allowed to heal inside All Mother. Huh. That caused a stir. Only matriarchs are allowed to enter the mountain. But you deserve the honor. The survivors had told everyone how you fought to save them.
I wasn't the only one to fight.
No. They spoke of Bast and Vala, too.
And Rost, the man who raised me. He fought to save me, and he died for it.
The survivors didn't speak of him, but I remember him. He was there that day when you saved me. I remember he stepped in front of you when my father started yelling. If by dying he saved your life, Aloy, I don't think he regretted it.
I need the gate opened.
Do you have any idea how dangerous it is out there?
I need to pass through.
You'll have to talk to Resh then, up on the wall. He's the new war chief. I'm not sure he'll help you.
What's the danger in the Embrace? Are the killers still there?
No. They're long gone. The war party went after them, but the killers slaughtered them. They have some evil power over the machines. They corrupt them, make them fight at their side.
And these corrupted machines, they're loose in the Embrace?
Some have broken through. And from what I hear, it's even worse outside the Embrace. Believe me, this is no time to go traveling.
Why wouldn't Resh help me?
Well, he says mean things about you.
That I'm a motherless curse, an outcast, that sort of thing?
Yeah. I wish he hadn't been made war chief, but Sona disappeared after the ambush. They say she went after the killers all by herself.
Who is Sona?
Sona was the tribe's war chief, but she went missing after the war party was ambushed. You probably saw her at Mother's Heart, a tall, lean woman with dark skin and long white hair. Her daughter ran in the proving, but she died.
Was Vala her daughter?
Yes, she was. I liked her.
So did I. What are you doing here with a bow and spear, Teb? You're a stitcher, not a brave.
Most of our braves are dead or wounded, Aloy. Someone has to defend Mother's Watch, so I thought I'd help out. I should be okay. Just as long as I don't try to run any brave trails, right?
I should be on my way, Teb.
May All Mother go with you.
The outcast approaches. Ignore her. Continue to report. There are rumors of a demon loose in the Embrace. A thing of dark metal that corrupts every machine it touches.
Where did it come from?
I need the gate opened.
Since when has any outcast's need been my concern?
Since I was anointed a seeker. Now open the gate.
You? A seeker? Have Tirsa and Jezza gone insane? Bad enough that they let you run in the proving. But to nurse you back to health inside the sacred mountain? No wonder a curse is upon us and children lie dead under cairns of stone.
How can you be so heartless? I fought beside those children, shoulder to shoulder and back to back. I saw them fall.
If even one of them had been true, Nora, they would have put an arrow in your back. Resh, come on. Silence! I am your war chief.
And I am a seeker anointed by the High Matriarchs. So open the gate, and I will be on my way.
The sooner you're gone from here, the better.
What was that?
Stop!
makes things worse with the killers at the proving. How does it possess other machines? How'd you do it? Show me. You made them obey you. How? This. You did it with this. It's connecting to my focus. Then I could use this. It's worth a shot. A couple loops of wire. Looks like it'll hold. I just need to test it.
Aloy! How did you do that? You killed that demon. Pulled its guts from the carcass.
The way it controls other machines. I think I figured it out. But I need to test it on a machine.
Plenty of striders along the path to the gates of the Embrace, I guess.
Exactly. And the gates are where I'll be headed anyway. I need to speak to Varl.
I always knew you were different, Aloy, but...
But what?
I think you're a blessing from All-Mother. No matter what Resh says.
Thank you, Teb. But I have to go now.
I know you do. And my thoughts go with you.
Braves! I want that gate repaired immediately! I don't care if you have to bandage it together. Get it done!
I need to find a machine and see what this device can do.